Hey, welcome to Real Vision. My name is Santiago Velez. I'm the R&D lead for Block Digital Corporation. And today I'm excited to bring with us Mr. Kevin Merko, CEO of CoinMetro. Welcome, Kevin.
Thank you, Santiago. Glad to be here.
Excellent. So today I'd like to get into some great discussions around exchanges and what you guys are doing at CoinMetro. But before we do that, I'd like to go into a little bit about yourself, your background, and kind of tell us about how you got into the space and what you bring uniquely versus other people in the exchange business.
Absolutely. So my background, most of my experience, at least when it comes to finance, is in FX. So I've been involved in Forex since the late 1990s into the early 2000s. And around that time, I started out as a trader, like most people would. You know, I read a book and thought, this is for me. Lost a lot of money in the journey, but ended up kind of getting my feet on the ground, going all the way to owning and running as a CEO a regulated FX brokerage. In about 2009, actually, I read the Bitcoin white paper. So I read it a few months after it had been written. And for me, it was all about tokenization of securities. That was the cool thing. I didn't really look too much into Bitcoin or exactly where that may go. To be honest, I think at the time, I didn't think, 10, 12, 13 years later, we would still be talking about Bitcoin. But this idea of these four merged technologies that could potentially add immutability and all this auditability into the financial markets is what really kind of sprung the interest in me, at least when it came to Bitcoin in the beginning and crypto in the beginning. And then around 2014 or 15 on the business side, I had a lot of clients in FX asking me if they could gain exposure to Bitcoin. And that started my journey really on the business side, because at the time there was nowhere to really get any real liquidity that was tradable, at least from a, let's say, risk off standpoint. I could market make, but there was no one that could really provide me with liquidity. So that's really where the journey started. And here we are today, and there's been a lot of speed bumps and pivots and things along the way, but I think I'm glad I made the move. That's what I can say about that.
One of the things in watching a lot of the podcasts that you do on your channel and listening to you at different conferences, as well as how your platform is run, is that there's this element of transparency, right? You know exactly as a user what you're going to get, and your expectations are met, right? There's a lot of competition in the exchange space, and that transparency really isn't there. But before we get into that, I'd like to talk a little bit about what do you consider are key attributes for a good exchange? What makes a good exchange? Why should a trader use CoinMetro versus, a Coinbase or Kraken or Binance?
Sure. I think in general, this goes across all markets. So it's not necessarily just about crypto. It could be equities. It could be FX. It could be, any tradable market. I think the first thing, look, most people that start their trading journeys need assistance. They need help. They need someone that they can contact 24/7 and really get help, not just get, take 3 months to get a response or get a canned response from maybe some automated system. And I think that's something that a lot of players in trading in general, whether, like I said, whichever market you may be talking about, don't really focus on. And that's a shame, because in general in finance, customer support is just terrible. And it's one of the industries where you really do need superior customer support. Like I said, when you first start out in a market, you have so many questions, especially in crypto, because in other markets, there's a standardization of platforms. So when you go and trade FX, you're going to be trading probably on the same platform, regardless of where you trade. There's very little, let's say, customized platforms in FX. Same thing with equities if you're a retail trader. When you're institutional, it's a bit different. But in crypto, there's no standardization. Everyone has their own platforms. Everybody puts things in different places. There's really no standardization across anything. So it's impossible for a new trader when they jump between platforms to understand what's going on. No matter how good the UX is, no matter how good the UI is, it can be an issue. So I think CoinMetro stands out in one place because of customer support. I mean, we really do focus 24/7, 365. Someone is there to help you. I think our Trustpilot rating hovers between 5 and 4.9. And everyone that goes on to Trustpilot says, at least when mentioning why they think CoinMetro is a good place to go trade, customer support's one of them. So even though that may not seem as an attribute from a financial platform, I think it's highly important. On the other side, when you're a trader, there's only a few things you look for. You may be looking for, certain types of platforms to trade on. You may be looking at potentially certain assets. But definitely one thing that everyone looks at is cost, right? Trading fees. And we have some of the lowest trading fees in the industry. Not only that, but as you said, we are transparent. So we don't try to hide fees behind, you know, really intricate layers of service. We don't try and stick fees somewhere where you might not be able to see them. Everything that we charge our clients, they know what we're charging them. And I think that's super important as well. And on the other side, and this is kind of highlighted what happens in FX, in crypto, when there are, let's say recoveries and or when you see large volatile moves in the market, right?
Yeah,
you
risk off, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. What happened when you see cascades and stop out cascades and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? Lots of exchanges go offline. And the reason they go offline is either because they're on the other side of those positions, which is probably the norm in most crypto exchanges. So they are taking some internal risk on your position. They're trading against you for the lack of a better term. And that in most market instances isn't necessarily a terrible thing. As a trader, you just want to be filled, right? So if you're filled, you don't necessarily care who fills you. However, when there's extreme volatility and you're being filled by the platform to which you're trading on, when there's extreme volatility, they are taking extreme risk. And in many times that means they're going to go offline. And we don't trade against our clients. Every single one of our trades is STP'd or straight through process right to a liquidity provider. We take on no risk inside of our own book, which means we actually align our goals with that of our clients. We want you to make money. We want you to be successful. The more successful you are, the more you trade, obviously the more money we make as a business. So I think those three things, aside from, you know, specific products, et cetera, which maybe we'll touch on a bit later, are some of the three core attributes that you should look for really in any broker, regardless of the market you're trading.
I hope you enjoyed this clip and will decide to join us for the rest of the interview, among many others, on realvision.com/crypto. The crypto channel is 100% free. You just have to sign up. Look forward to seeing you there.